Welcome, Flyers fans. You're listening to Chris Mayer, Flyers Fan Mania 93 on YouTube.
Alright, what is up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Chris, and today I'm back with another video here. Some World Juniors coverage again. Switzerland against Russia. Brian Zanetti playing for Switzerland. Basically, played a lot more minutes than I honestly thought he was going to, just because of everything that kind of had gone on in the last recent years with the way that younger guys were kind of treated that I kind of mentioned with New York. I had a feeling Zanetti was maybe going to play third pair, maybe second penalty kill unit. He basically was used as a third, fourth defenseman. Theoretically, he's playing first pair. I kind of got some help on that with Alex, thank you. But again, overall, I thought Zanetti played a really solid game for what Switzerland kind of did and for how Russia played against them. The Swiss only had, I believe, 15 shots on net at the end of the game. And, you know, that was kind of the storyteller in this one was it was heavily favored in Russia's favor from the puck possession. Obviously, they won the game 4-1, or excuse me, 4-2. And I thought Zanetti played really well. I mean, for what he is and for his age, I thought he had some really good plays and just played the way that he knows he can play. And one thing I will give the Swiss is they always battle, no matter if who they're playing, what the score is, and whatever the outcome is at the end of it, they definitely did battle hard. So in the first period, Zanetti was on the open shift. It was pretty even hockey for the first few minutes. There really weren't many chances or shots. There was one shot in the first 7 minutes of play. The Swiss had their best chance off the Russian. It was a good save, and the Russia came back the other way and scored to make 1-0. It was just a shot from the outside circle. Went off two Austrian players' skates. It was kind of like a pinball machine. Just kind of deflected, and it just zigzagged into the net. So 1-0 Russia there. Zanetti had the puck got to him, quickly fired it, but it deflected wide. It was a shot from the point. 2-0 Russia. They hit the post the first time. Second time it was in. Russian player literally just fired it from the corner, picked up his own rebound, turned, just kind of fired it. Ended up going in. 2-0 Russia there. Zanetti he's having a little open gap control. He's had some really good plays where, Michkov had a chance where he kind of went between the legs around him, made a really nice move there, scored on that the other day in Sweden. Zanetti kind of gave him a little bit of room, and he actually defended it well, and it was a smart move by Michkov to get around him. But, that kid's incredible. I mean, I could talk about that kid all day, but Zanetti, I thought, made a good play recovering on him. I didn't like the way he kind of started to cover him, but he made a good recovery play on that. Then Russia would make it 3-0. It was a shot from the slot off of just a spin around shot, brutal bounce, and then finding a stick in the slot. It was just a shot from the point, found a stick in the slot, kind of just turned and fired it, went right through the arm there, 3-0. And then the Swiss would score, make it 3-1 on the 2-1 rush, 1-1 puck battle. They go up the ice, quick shot goes in, it's 3-1. So in the second period, Kevin Pash had two beautiful saves. First one was diving back with the paddle, then he slid back over, stoned a one-timer before that. It was just unbelievable. He made two really good saves. The first one, just slid over, got upstairs with the blocker, really nice save there, and then he was just diving back with the paddle to keep that one out. I mean, he had a couple of desperation saves. Definitely was a big reason why this game was close for the majority of it. Switzerland gets a power play, they had a shorthanded chance. Russia gets fired, but Switzerland throws the short-handed chance. Russia had a nice chance in the slot on a one-timer there, but that ended up getting killed off. Zanetti had a pretty nice gap control again, took me out of the wall, took care of him behind the net. I really liked what he did. He just played solid defensive hockey, didn't do anything crazy, and put his D partner and put him in a bad spot. He didn't put really anybody in a bad spot either. He didn't have many turnovers, nothing crazy. He just played good hockey, and I think for being that, and being he's very poised for being 18, and that's one thing that I like about him. He's able to move the puck well, and he definitely did. He definitely was able to do that in this game, and I thought he just had an overall had a really solid game doing that. Russia had a lot of territorial play. That was one thing. They had a lot of territorial play in the first period, second, kept that going in the third. Overall, I thought it was just a. It kind of felt like Russia was kind of starting to get better as the tournament goes on. That kind of seems like what they always kind of do. It kind of takes them some time, and you know, they haven't necessarily been scoring great goals, but they've scored some crazy ones, and you know, I felt like a couple of the ones that were kind of some lucky bounces, but sometimes you need lucky bounces to get them going, and that might be something that Rush kind of needs to get them going for the rest of the tournament as well. But it was still 3-1 after the second. Russia, Ponomarev almost scored on the between the legs move. Would have been disgusting. I cannot believe I actually didn't mess up that name. Switzerland gets a power play, pretty bad call, honestly. It was a retaliation call. I really didn't like it, regardless of, you know, it being Zanetti on Switzerland and, you know, me watching for Zanetti. I just thought it was a pretty bad call at that time, but it happens, and no goal there. They had two shots, they had a post. Switzerland's definitely getting some momentum. They were moving the puck well, they had more zone time, they were starting to pressure. And one thing Greg Button had said to kind of just throw pucks on net, and they kind of were doing that at times, but they ended up kind of stopping. They definitely played better, as I said. Pash had really to save on one timer, and then Russia would come down kind of the 4-1-2 form, one kind of play down low, and they ended up scoring. Each guy scored right and tight to make it 4-1. Austria would score late on the deflection. They also would have a power play there as the Swiss. Actually, had a power play after that when they made it 4-2. It was a delay game call. And that was a play where you thought they might have been able to get back into the game, but they couldn't. I had a couple chances, but the game ended up ending. I don't know why, but I put Austria in my notes, and I really don't understand why I've done that. I do that all the time when I watch these tournaments. I mess up the Austrian and Switzerland against the colors, but my apologies there. I also had a brutal brain fart the other night. With UAE and Canada, if you notice that is totally my bad. But anyway, all jokes aside, it's been a lot of hockey for me to watch, so sometimes when I mess up, it's not intentional, it just happens. But overall, I thought Zanetti had a really good game for what the kid can bring, and for him being 18 years old, I thought he played pretty poised, moved the puck well, and I'm really excited to watch the rest of the tournament. He definitely did surprise me today, so. If you do catch this game, let me know your guys' thoughts below. Remember to check out Buttons. You can use code PHI for 10% off any products. Also, Garrett Group Construction for any home improvement needs. Thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you all again soon.